this world needs stories like this. Points of history, these Neil Armstrong first man on the moon moments that can galvanize the world, especially in the times we live in. Racial division, pandemic challenges that we're dealing with in the last several years, tremendous strife politically around the world. It just seems hopeless unless you are privy to these kinds of stories, to these true stories of profound life change. The last well is going to be drilled. The last village is going to be reached with clean water. Every unreached village and community across Liberia will have been reached. It'll be the first country with border-to-border basic water access in history. We're at the end. We're at the finish line. We're feet from the ribbon of a marathon race. Our collective chest is about to break it, and it's an amazing feeling. This is just the beginning. This will rewrite the discussion of humanitarian aid around the world. The last well's got an incredible story, really. I was a pastor of a church up in the DC area called Frontline. And in 2009, there was a movie that came out called Amazing Grace about William Wilberforce. He was credited with ending slavery in the UK a couple hundred years ago. It was an incredible story of a man literally giving his life, you know, for a cause. You know, we had 4,000 young adults coming to this church, and all of them, it seemed, had seen this movie. All of them had their heart pierced by that story and wanted to change the world. And out of that, the last well was born. That's where we came up with a mission to bring clean water to an entire country, Liberia, and do it by 2020. There are a lot of organizations reaching needy people with clean water. They're everywhere. But no one's ever taken on the task of going border to border in a single country. When we started, we estimated there would be 2,000 wells needed for the country. We've done 11,000 projects, almost 4,000 wells, and 7,000 more communities, more than 7,000, that were provided filters in their homes, these clean water systems that will provide them clean water for anywhere from 7 to 10 years. It's the largest effort of its kind ever.
Everybody said that Liberia would be impossible to reach, especially where we went with the filters. Nobody goes there, nobody could go there. They said it couldn't be done, but it has been done. The teams have driven as far as they could drive and crossed rivers and hiked for hours to get to villages. And we're here in this last one right now, giving clean drinking water to a village that honestly probably would have been written off. It's not big enough to receive a hand pump well. And so they would have just had to do without, but they don't anymore.
So we have passionate staff and volunteers, and our teams in the field are exceptional. Everybody believes in this mission. They've given their blood, sweat, and tears. It's a tireless effort over 12 years by incredibly passionate people to help their own people and transform their nation in the process. And they've done that. They've done it. 3.2 million people now have access to clean water because of the efforts of the last well and its partners. But in addition to that, and I think more important for me, the UN estimates that 5% of a given population without access to clean water over a 10-year period will die. That's 150,000 lives that have been saved over the last 12 years. 150,000 people who have not seen their next birthday, but for the work of these Liberians. That's astonishing to me. So where we find ourselves is in this amazing place. After 12 years of the challenges and the loss and the cost of this, we find ourselves at the finish line. Our chest has broken the ribbon. You know, we're past the finish line. We're in the celebration phase, right? The crowds have gone wild at the end of the marathon inside the stadium.
You've been waiting 12 years for this moment. Come on.
Got it done.
Keep going, fill that bucket up. I think you got a bucket boot.
What?
Hey, I see you there. What do you want me to do with this water now? I know what I'm gonna do with this water.
Uh-oh.
Water
is life.
Huh?
This is an amazing moment for all of Liberia.
Yes, sir.
I wish you could see all of the other villages. Villages just like this one. 11,000 of them all over the country who have dedicated wells and water filters with Sawyer all over the country. 1:25 p.m. November 12, 2020. A 12-year mission is over.
So from here, finishing Liberia, reaching this country border to border, finishing the mission, people often ask us what's next. And I really believe that this is a movement and the ability for us and others to scale on what we've done here, it can be done very, very quickly. If we knew what we know now, Liberia would not have taken 12 years, it would have taken 4. We really believe that we can take this system and eradicate global water issues, eradicate waterborne illness around the world. It's time. The technology's there, the passion is there, the ability to travel around the world, it's there. We have everything at a perfect junction to transform the world. And that's what we'll be doing. This is the last well in Liberia. It's not the last well. We have more work to do. In fact, we think this is just the beginning.